This video is designed to help you quickly find information in the ClinVar database at NCBI. ClinVar is a database of genomic variants and the interpretations of their relevance to disease. Although it is maintained at NCBI, the interpretations are provided by clinical testing labs, research labs, locus-specific databases, expert panels, and other groups who want to share data to improve variant interpretation. There are several ways to search ClinVar, depending on your needs. Basically, you start on the ClinVar homepage, type something in the search bar at the top, and click Search. Let's look at a few examples. One scenario is that you want all variants in a certain gene. Let's say you're interested in the ZEB2 gene. Just type in ZEB2 and click Search. Since I used the official gene symbol for this homeobox gene, the page automatically restricted the results to only the ZEB2 gene, omitting records that may simply mention ZEB2. Your results are presented in a table with the name of the variant, the gene it's in, the conditions for which the variants have been interpreted, allele frequency if available, the overall clinical significance, and the review status. This search has more than 200 results, but you can narrow them by using the filters on the left. For example, you may only be interested in variants that have been reported as pathogenic, or you may want large-scale structural variants. A second scenario is that you have a specific variant that you are researching. There are several ways to search for a variant description, but a full HGVS expression with an accession.version number is the most specific. For example, this change from T to A at position 1799 on this RefSeq mRNA version 4. I first need to clear my filter, then I'll run that search by hitting the Enter key. When you use a query that has a single result, you'll go right to the variant page, not the results table. You can search for less specific nucleotide descriptions, like 1799 T to A BRAF, or just 1799 T to A, or for a dbSNP RS number. But be aware that these less specific queries may return more results than you expect. For example, more than one gene may have the variant, and an RS number may represent more than one allele at the same location. Similarly, you can search for protein descriptions with a full HGVS expression, or with less specific terms, like just the p.val600glu, or even just v600e. But again, these may give you multiple results, because some protein changes can be caused by more than one nucleotide change, and well-known variants like V600E may be mentioned in summaries about other variants. A third scenario is finding variants within a specific genomic region. You might be interested in structural variants in a certain cytogenetic region, or affecting a certain gene, or in sequence variants in a particular exon of a gene. The most convenient way to search for variants in a genomic region is within the Variation Viewer, a genome browser for variation information at NCBI. I used the viewer's search box to focus on the ZEB2 gene. This region is the genome browser with the genome coordinates along the top and tracts of data below, including genes, ClinVar variations, and many other tracts that you can specify using the tracts menu. Below the browser is a table with more information about features in this region. The left side has a nice set of filters to control the view. For more details, see our other YouTube videos on the Variation Viewer and Genome browsers. The blue and red bars in the dbVar track represent large duplications and deletions, respectively. You can use the zoom bar to see these structural variants at different scales. And you can zoom into a smaller region like a single exon to look at individual variants within that exon. Or zoom all the way to the sequence level. Notice that the browser section interacts with the table below. For example, if you limit to ClinVar records, you see that there is one ClinVar record from dbSNP and 12 from dbVar in the displayed region. In addition to the filters, the table gives you a summary for each variant, including the most severe clinical significance column, where the links go to the corresponding ClinVar record. So this approach can take you from a genome-based query to a specific ClinVar record. Finally, you may be interested in searching for variants that have been reported for a specific disease or phenotype. In some cases, the disease for the variant is unknown, but there are phenotypes that were observed in individuals with the variant, such as hypertonia and seizures. You can search for both types of terms in ClinVar. For example, if you search for the disease cystic fibrosis, you get more than 1,000 records, and you can see that many of these variants were interpreted with respect to cystic fibrosis. Let's now search for the phenotype hypertonia seizures. This gives you several results, but neither of these terms appear in the conditions column. However, you may find these phenotypes within individual records. For example, I'll click on this third result and scroll down to the assertion and evidence details section. There is no condition in the interpretation, but there is a link to the supporting observations tab. On that tab, you see that hypertonia and seizures were both observed in an individual with this particular variant. That ends our brief tour of ClinVar searches. Be sure to take advantage of these menus below the search bar, the help link, and our responsive email contact, clinvar@ncbi.nlm.nih.gov.